Hey, what's up, everybody? Leahey's Locker Room coming back to the Valley Isle and talking with Kamehameha Maui head football coach Cody Nakamura. This is year two of the Cody Nakamura era for the Warriors. Former tight end with Weber State, so you have certainly an offensive-minded approach in many respects as a head coach. Talk about the offense for this team. Chase Newton at the helm, a really good athlete, throws, runs. Talk about the offensive philosophy and how they all fit in.
Well, it's definitely good to have an athlete like Chase Newton back there. He's smart. He's athletic. He can throw. He can run. So that helps as far as preparing a scheme for defenses. And, you know, they got to worry about a lot of things when he's back there. So that helps a lot. And he's another guy who was studying all year long. He knows the playbook in and out. He knows every single position, what they need to do. So that helps when he's out there. He's kind of a coach out there, and he's making sure everybody's on the same page.
Now, maybe other programs in the MIL and across the state have better win-loss records right now than Kamehameha Maui. That said, there is no head coach or football program that has a better football field facility with this kind of vista than what you have right here. Talk about just having this at your disposal as a head coach of a high school program.
Oh, it's definitely good. I mean, it's definitely a plus for us. It gives us a slight advantage somewhat. You know, it's this facility here is better than most college facilities that I've seen. It's definitely better than the one at Weber State. So, you know, we take advantage of it as much as we can.
You've been known to have a few VIPs that roll through practice over here, too, during training camp. And another one who was remarking on how beautiful this view is, Eric Spoelstra, Miami Heat head coach. He came by last offseason. Talk about that.
Oh, yeah, it was a great experience. Coach Helle has a connection there that, you know, he was able to come up, and we scheduled it for camp. He came up. First thing he did, he walked into the gate, and he stopped and he took a picture. And when you think about the venues that he's seen around the world, I'm sure they're he's seen it all. And when he comes over to this stadium and he stops and he takes a picture, you know you got something special.
Give you any tips, head coach to head coach?
No, not yet. You know, he talked to the kids for about half an hour, I'd say, and he gave some good pointers to them. The one thing that I took away from what he told the kids is he held the football up, and that's what he was talking to the kids about. You know, this little thing right here can take you anywhere, and it's just, you know, what you put into it and what you believe.
Well, you're putting a lot into this, certainly, and building on something here at Kamehameha Maui, and we wish you the best of luck here the rest of the season and going forward the rest of the Cody Nakamura era. Thank you, Coach.
Thank you very much.
All right, that's it for Leahey's Locker Room. We'll send it back to the studio.
All right, fellas, it's that time of the night giving out plate lunches and slushies, courtesy of our friends at Rainbow Drive-In. Brian, who's getting your two scoops tonight?
My two scoops are staying right here in Honolulu. It's going out to Keith Amemiya, former HHSAA executive director, and also the author of the Save Our Sports campaign that started off in 2011, I believe. It's raised $1.5 million for schools here in Hawaii.
He definitely threw the alley-oop. Chris Chun throwing it down these
Absolutely.
Days. Barney the Dinosaur, Sam Spangler. Who's getting yours?
Mine's headed up to the North Shore. Hauʻoli Kikaha, Kahuku grad, University of Washington linebacker, Lot Impact National Player of the Week, 3 sacks versus Illinois in a fumble recovery. Also gets it done in the classroom, 3.5 GPA, academic all Pac-12 first teamer.
Awesome stuff. Mine going to another Kahuku alum, former Ravens Super Bowl champ Maʻake Kemoiatu. He retired from the NFL in order to donate his kidney to his brother Chris, a 3-time Super Bowl champ with the Steelers, who is suffering from kidney disease. For the complete story of amazing selflessness, check out KHON2.com. Well, that does it for us. For Sam Spangler, Brian Teo, Kanoa Leahey, our director Paul Higa, and our entire Cover 2 crew, I'm Rob DeMello. Thanks for watching, everybody. Aloha.
We need you guys. That's one part of coming around.